Christine Susan Munro. Bred in California nurse, Susan Munro was just 37 years old when she went for a jog along the Sacramento River Trail in 1995. The mother of four would never be seen alive again. Sadly, she jogged by a man with evil intentions who was lying in wait. Eventually, he jumped out and overpowered Susan. She was physically forced into submitting to him, and when he finished, he brutally stabbed her to death. In addition to the questions of who and why he left behind, he also left behind his DNA. However, in 1995, DNA wasn't what it is today, and the case went cold. A convicted rapist falsely confessed to the crime in 1997, but there was insufficient evidence to prove that he was the killer. The case would go cold again, and the question would eventually be answered. James Watkins was serving a 14-year sentence for robbery in the state of Texas. In January of 2020, detectives resubmitted fingernail scrapings that were collected in evidence from Susan Munro's murder. They were submitted to the California Department of Justice and eventually entered into CODIS. CODIS matched the evidence to the DNA of James Watkins, 42, of Texas. So we now know that when Watkins was lying in wait for the mother of four, he was just 17 years old, barely starting out on his path of crime, a path that would be his undoing in the end. Nurse Susan Munro's murder went unsolved for 25 years. Watkins was arrested in late 2020 after DNA evidence linked him to the abduction and killing. A judge ordered Watkins to stand trial in March of 2021. As a result, Watkins was extradited to Shasta County from Texas in November of 2020. Instead of a trial, the state accepted a guilty plea after speaking with Susan's remaining living three children. They agreed to three life sentences without the possibility of parole. Under the terms of the plea deal, Watkins waived all of his appeal rights. In return, he won't face the death penalty. He will be officially sentenced August 25th, 2021 in Shasta County Superior Court. The next case is that of Diane Vegas. Chester Vegas Sr. was a widower with a wife who was murdered in Louisiana in 1977. His wife was then just 32 years old. Turns out he was much more than just a widower. He was also the killer. A more than four-decade-old murder case in Louisiana was closed with the arrest of the victim's now elderly husband. Chester Vegas Sr., 78, of Golden Meadow, was arrested for second-degree murder charge in the October 10, 1977 death of his wife. Diane was just 32 years old when she was found with a bullet in her back, lying in the middle of the floor of the Chicken House, a restaurant in Golden Meadow that was owned by both Diane and her husband. At the time, Chester called the police, saying that he found her there, and the cash register had been tampered with, and the phone was off the hook. For 44 years, Diane's family has lived with the question of who took her life. The police immediately considered Chester a person of interest, questioning him in her death. However, after a friend provided an ironclad alibi, he was released without charges. For 40 years, he went on living his life, and the case went cold. Then an informant came forward stating that Chester admitted to him that he killed Diane all those years ago. This inspired the police to go ahead and re-question Chester's alibi, and that person in turn recanted. Then a second person came forward stating that Chester also confessed to him. Chester would be arrested and then released from custody after a $50,000 bond was posted. The sheriff went on to state that he hopes the arrest can bring closure to the victim's family. We hope this arrest can begin to bring some closure to the Vegas family, who have been living with questions about Diane's death for nearly 44 years. New information combined with the initial investigation helped us build probable cause for the arrest. He has been charged with second-degree murder. Our third case is that of Virginia Ginny Hannon. Ginny was a beloved childhood memory to many kids growing up in Pembroke, North Carolina. She was a much-loved lunch lady in a local elementary school. She was always cheerful and always smiling. She made the days better for children year after year. She worked in the school for decades, and the kids meant everything to her. Her nephew, Rich Hannon, spoke of what a great woman she was. She was great with kids and a great cook and just a great person. She was always happy. Ginny was 59, widowed, with no children, living alone in her house on West Street until someone broke in and brutally murdered her by both stabbing and strangling her in 1984. Her case went unsolved for decades. After 37 years of silence and no answers, the DNA of a Brockton man with no known link to Ginny at all solved the mystery of who senselessly took Ginny's life. Unfortunately, by the time DNA identified Jesse Alward as the murderer, he was beyond being held to justice. He had passed away the year before. Virginia Hannon's family say they think that there is more to the story, but they're happy to at least have some kind of closure for their loss. The wife of Ginny's nephew indicated the family's greatest wish would be seeing him taken away in handcuffs to face charges for what he did, from what he took from them, but she's grateful to have this small amount of closure, to know who committed the crime. They described Ginny as smiling, wonderful. She liked to play bingo and drink beer with ice in it. She was a champion baker and she was always on the go. She was the kind of person who never met a stranger, and she always found a way to find common ground with anyone she met. In fact, even the officers working her case knew Ginny from when she served them lunch when they were in grade school. She was truly an important part of the community. On February 4th, 2020, a friend of Jesse's came forward and called authorities. He said he needed to tell them that Jesse confessed on his deathbed at the age of 57 that he murdered Hannon. Jesse declined to say why he did it, and he was just 22 years old at the time. No known motive has been discovered. Police took his DNA and compared it to that of Hannon's murderer. The DNA did match. After 37 years, Jenny's family finally got some closure. Well, that's it for today, everybody. Thank you so much for listening and watching. If you haven't yet, please take a moment, subscribe. We're halfway to that magic number of 1,000 subscribers. Well, almost halfway there. Take care of yourselves and each other.